Welcome to all of you. I won't do the good morning, good afternoon, good evening because we're in so many different time zones, but I hope that wherever you are, that you are well and that your beloveds and that you are safe. Just a quick overview of how we're going to do the day today. I am going to lead us through a quick body scan check-in mindfulness exercise, which is how we pretty much begin all of our sessions. And then I'm just going to go through a quick recap of the prior sessions on presence, on listening, and on generative conflict, because those are very critical elements of how we then create a culture of care. I'm going to begin with our check-in with ourselves, because one of the key elements of leadership, of interconnected leadership, is really learning how to become present with ourselves. So I invite you to settle into a comfortable position. If you can have your feet on the ground, if your legs are crossed, uncross them. Bring your eyes closed or into a soft gaze, whatever is easier for you. If you have a practice, you can sit in that way. And just start getting settled into your seats. If you're sitting, standing, just allow yourself to arrive fully into this global community that has gathered today to talk about the culture of care. And just bring your attention to your breath and allow yourself to do an inhale and a slightly longer exhale. And if there's sound that's wanting to be released, just allow yourself to sound. It's been quite a time. Couple of more breaths. Just allow yourself to feel that breath taking in oxygen. Exhaling carbon dioxide. And just notice that we are all breathing the same air around the world. As we are in deep relationship with the trees who give us the oxygen that we breathe and take in the carbon dioxide that we exhale, this beautiful symbiotic relationship with the planet. And now from the top of your head, start scanning down. And just notice what's happening in your body. Sensations, heat, cold, warm, cool parts. Any vibrations, tingling, numbness. Constriction, expansion, relaxation. What's going on with your body? We are so disconnected from ourselves, especially as leaders. We focus so much on changing everything around us that we often forget to just check in right here with these miracles of our bodies within which our lives exist. And now just allow yourself to feel into your emotions, your feelings. Your thoughts. Just get present with all of the different parts of yourself. And now see if you can allow your larger self, your higher self, whatever you call that self, to hold all of that, your sensations in your body, your emotions, your feelings, your thoughts. Be present with all of you. This is one of the most critical components to building a culture of care. We need to be connected to ourselves so that we can be present for others. Just take a couple of more deep breaths and bring yourself back into this circle. So now truly welcome everyone as we step into this conversation around how we build a culture of care. Just a few framing thoughts before I go into slides. Slides are a little challenging for me because when I start sharing my screen, I can't see anybody. And that's hard for me because so much of my being in the circle is really interacting with all of you, even though it's on Zoom and in this digital space. So the word care, has huge history and meaning, especially in feminist movements. We have had to address the question of care in such a multiplicity of ways, from gender norms around who does care, who provides care, to structural and economic systems around how care is valued, how care is paid for, how care is compensated, how care is supported, to larger systemic issues of how care is undermined and how many, many parts of our global community are simply not cared for, to how we think about the planet and our relationship of care with the earth and how we show up. And so, since we have only the short amount of time together, I would like to suggest that rather than getting into a discussion about the politics of care and how it has existed, particularly in feminist circles in the past, that we invite ourselves into a conversation about understanding that and stepping into the possibility that this moment of COVID is allowing for us in terms of how we step into the creation of the present and the future. But first, what I would like to do is do a quick recap of where we've been in this journey around interconnected leadership so that we can step into our conversation about care from a shared place of framing. So, what is interconnected leadership? Well, interconnected leadership is many, many things. For the purposes of the work that we've been doing together in these last couple of sessions, interconnected leadership is leadership that makes sure that it takes into account the self, community, systemic structures and policies, as well as the planet, into account in whatever it is that it does in the world. How do interconnected leaders act in the world? From a place of understanding the relationship amongst these four domains, if you will. Community is a placeholder for organizations, for religious institutions, educational institutions, families, larger community structures within which we live, perhaps even our countries. Systems are the systemic ways in which we have organized ourselves. And planet, of course, is a recognition that our relationship is to all beings on this earth, and that we are, in fact, made of nature and part of nature, that our life support system is the planet on which we all exist. This is the last of four sessions on interconnected leadership. In the first session, we discussed the importance of presence and connection as leaders. In the second, we took a deep dive into deep listening. In the third, we explored how to make conflict and tension more generative, create new possibilities. And in this session, we're going to take a deeper dive into a culture of care and well-being. In the presence and connection session, we introduced the body scan exercise that I just led us through to really understand how important self-awareness is, how important it is for us to be aware of what our own needs are, what our own healing needs are, what our own care needs are, so that we can really be in presence, identify purpose, and be committed in thought, word, and action to our purpose and to the world it is that we desire to create together. In deep listening, we explored skills of how to be present and to listen to other people without our own story interrupting their stories, how to be in a place without negating, without judgment, without shutting down other people, how to use the wonderful principle that I learned in improv, the yes and principle of if somebody says something, how do we build on it rather than shutting it down? How do we affirm and add? And also how we do listening, not from a fixed identity place, but from a place of curiosity so that we're prepared to allow something new to perhaps get created out of a dialogue or a conversation that we may be having with another person or with a group, or indeed even with the earth itself. In the third session, we focused on generative conflict, the importance of how we create more connection instead of rupturing relationships, especially in a patriarchal structure where divide, power over, exploitative structures of you and me, us versus them have been the norm. How do we start to shift that? How do we create more learning opportunities from conflict? And how do we navigate conflict and tension so that we can be more positively changed on the other side? Some of the practices around conflict, how we need to be aware of our own emotions, needs, and thoughts from a place of being resourced, not depleted, so we can really be present. Really understand intersectionality, understand how power and privilege play out around race, class, gender, sexuality, geographic location, ethnicity, 100 other identities that determine who has power and privilege and who is exploited, and also curiosity. I'm not going to get into this slide because it's a much deeper dive into how we identify conflict versus tension. I invite you to watch the last session if this is calling to you and you want to learn more about this. You can watch all of the earlier sessions. Quick focus on our habitual responses to fear and anxiety. This is important because we are living in a moment that is generating a lot of fear and anxiety. We are in unknown, uncharted territory. Old structures and systems are collapsing. We might be, our communities might be, our families might be in a lot of pain. We may have people that we are losing. And so having an understanding of our own habitual responses to fear or anxiety that get developed when we are very young is really important. And you can see on the slide, fight, flight, freeze, fog, and fawn are some of the ways in which we respond. And how we shift is on this slide as well. If you're somebody who's usually combative, try moving into dance. If you are somebody who looks to run away, maybe try warrior pose. And again, I'm not going to go through each one, What's really important to remember is that in many instances, your habitual response might be exactly the response that is needed. So the point of this is not to say that fight, flight, or freeze is not okay. It's simply to say become aware of your process so you can make a choice, so you can respond to a situation rather than simply reacting to a situation. So you become present in your leadership. So that was just a very quick overview of where we've been. And I know that was quick and fast. And again, I welcome you to go and look at the earlier videos if any of this is resonating. And for those of you who've been on the journey with me from the outset, I hope that was helpful just to bring us into the current context of where we are. Now, a lot of times when we talk about a culture of care and well-being, we kind of fall into either sort of this notion of, you know, whether we can get a massage, whether we can engage in contemplative practices, or as I mentioned when we started out the conversation, we immediately start thinking about care economies where women are doing a lot of the caretaking, or where women are doing a lot of the caretaking within familial structures, which is not even recognized by the economic systems. We are seeing in the midst of this pandemic the absolutely critical nature of care. Who is providing care, how care is being supported, and how we are not caring. So examples, with shelter at home in place in so many countries, housework, which has traditionally been something that women have had to bear the responsibility of, has expanded even more to be their responsibility. Care around violence in the home has come to a place where the pandemic COVID is coinciding with the pandemic of domestic violence and leading to all kinds of situations of great danger for women. Care around our healthcare workers and how they are taking care of, with or without support from the public health system or the state. Care around how we are treating the most vulnerable in our societies. What is happening to workers who are needing to navigate safe passage to their homes across India is one of the most cruel, non-caring, uncaring versions of this pandemic that we are seeing, right? How are we dealing with our organization? So we're seeing care and well-being being played out at the level of self, family, community, organization, society in general, in our systems, in our structures, in our policies, in our relationship to nature, in our interconnectedness with all things. And so this is an incredible opportunity for us to ask, how do we build a culture of care from all that we have learned as leaders, as organizers, as activists, as shamans, as healers, as practitioners, of dreamers, of people who believe that we can create a new world? What does it mean to build a culture of care in the midst of this pandemic? And I'm just going to leave this slide up for a moment and let you just sort of read some of it. I mean, these are just some of the questions that I have been asking about how do we move into a place where we are being creative and generative about what we want to bring in while we are attending to the huge negative consequences towards some of the most vulnerable communities in our countries, in the world, at the time of COVID. Are we able to live in the paradox of addressing and reacting to what is needed right now while also holding a place for creative possibility as interconnected leaders, as leaders practicing a leadership that is simultaneously looking at the possibilities that can help us to create the world that we have all been dreaming about for decades? So some of those questions have to do with what are the values that we want to uphold? What are the new rules? What are the new beliefs? What are the principles of creating a culture of care? What are the actions that we need to take? How does this affect the policies and the systems we want to create? Are people already doing this? We have seen the most extraordinary examples of how people are caring and stepping in for one another and with one another. And we certainly have a long history of knowing how we have done this in the past. How can we draw on those stories, that wisdom, what we are already creating, to uplift those stories, not just the stories of harm, the stories of solutions and the stories of new possibilities? And then the last thing I have on this slide for us is, what are the resources, what are the conditions, what are the enabling circumstances that we need to start putting into place to create this new paradigm? And that is at the level of self, community, the planet. How are you taking care of yourself in this moment, in this time of pandemic? And these are just some categories to be thinking about in terms of self-care. Like I said, we often think about care in a very, very limited way. So this is just a beginning framework to help you expand the notion of what it means to create a culture of care for yourself. Physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, or contemplative, if the word spiritual is not a word that is easy for you to connect with. Really, it's about how are you taking care of multiple dimensions of your being, of yourself. And then there are many, many additional principles that we could be discussing in terms of creating a culture of care at the organizational level. And I have put this in here because many of you on this call, on this gathering, are in organizations, are leading organizations, have leadership positions on boards of organizations, or are affiliated with organizations in some way. So just some things to think about. Do you focus on relationships or are you more transactional? How does the question of wages get addressed in your organization? Where does sustainability have a role? And how are you addressing issues of inclusion, diversity, and equity? And I've used the inclusion, diversity, and equity language here just because we're all familiar with it. You know, it has its potential and its limitations. The point being, how are you making sure that all of the different parts of your organization are being taken care of? And let's frame both of these conversations around this pandemic moment. What is happening with self-care and what is happening with organizational care at this moment that is giving you some glimmer into what it is that you want to be creating? What are some things that you are learning that you want to actually make part of your ongoing practice that then becomes part of our ongoing combined work to create a culture of care and well-being for our planet. So we have 1 minute left and we may go over by a minute. I would just like to close this series out with one quick reflection, and then I just want us to do our 1 minute closing meditation. So the first thing that I want to say is a huge thank you to all of you who are here. There are so many beloved faces and so many new faces. Many of you have been here for all four sessions. I am incredibly grateful. It is so important for us to come together to do this work around creating interconnected leadership. The NGO Commission on the Status of Women is doing incredibly important work around bringing the voices of women activists from around the world together to dream this new way of being, a new planetary system. So I really invite you, if you're not a part of that community, to join and stay connected to all of their offerings. And I would love for you to stay connected to my offerings on my website at mallikadats.com. I will continue to do these kinds of virtual sessions around how we promote interconnectedness moving forward. And so since we are out of time, I'm going to just have us do a really quick close meditation. Huge thank you to the NGO Commission on the Status of Women for this series. And I invite you to come back again into your breath. Let your eyes close, go into soft focus. And this time allow your breath to come straight into your heart. Just allow your breath to come into your heart, that amazing organ, that large pumping organ in your body that gives you life, that is about life. And just allow your heart to fill with love. Love for this beautiful planet, Mother Earth, that gives us everything. The air we breathe, the water we drink, the food we eat, the clothes we wear, our homes. Just allow that love to spread across the lands, envelop the trees, the four-legged, the two-legged, the hundred-legged. The ones that swim, the ones that fly, the ones that crawl. All members of our species, especially the ones that might need that love right now. And feel our hearts connecting around that world as we share and spread our heart energy, our hearts, with one another and everything around us. And with the next inhale, allow yourself to gather that love and bring it back to yourself. And let the love of this earth fill you, nourish you, remind you how cherished you are. From this place of love, I say thank you to all of you. Thank you for being with me through this journey. I hope you continue to stay with me in this journey. I thank you for all of the incredible work that you are doing wherever you are, in your gardens, in your countries, around the world.